Thank you. and welcome to tonight's live Twitch stream. I hope every single one of you is doing good. And tonight's game is the Uruguay Futsal Final from 2018. So, what do we know about this game? Well, obviously, both teams are going to be from Uruguay, and because it's going to be a South American affair, you know it's going to be high standard. So, it's the men category. As I said, it's the Uruguay final, so it'll be what you would hope to be the two best teams in Uruguay. And yeah, I'm really excited to see this one. So again, what I've tried to do to try and make it a little bit more exciting for me, instead of picking a game every single day, I've picked throughout the week. So I'll be totally honest, I cannot remember who's playing, who won, or what the score is. So actually, what that does for me is it makes my reactions a little bit more real, which, to be fair, most of them are anyway. But obviously, it's nice to not know the score lines and everything else. And yeah, I'm really, really looking forward to today. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give out a shout out to all the people that have currently commented in the stream. If you can't comment, it's probably because you don't have the Twitch app or you've not followed our account. If you would like to get the Twitch app, please do, and follow our account, and it will allow you to comment during the stream, and that will allow you to offer, ask me questions, and just give me a little bit of thoughts, your thoughts on the game, really. If for any reason you're still getting problems, comment, you can just message me personally. It's not so easy to read it that way, but I have had people message me on WhatsApp and things like that in the past, and I have responded. So I will try and do that my best as well. But let's start with welcome Callum West, welcome Jackson, welcome Alejandro, welcome Kobe. They are the people that have commented so far. If you are with me live right now, please let me know that you are with me. And like I said before, I would love to hear from you guys, answer any questions that you have, and just talk futsal whilst I try and break this game down for you. Okay, let's go.
Del Gimle 74, están hablando con los árbitros. Se va a venir el partido en cualquier momento.
So to start with again, look at the crowds. This is a big theme that we've particularly spoken about in Europe. We have to get we need to get bigger crowds, get more fans of futsal. In South America, it doesn't matter what South American country it is, it just tends to be the moment club teams play, boom, sold out. Yes, this is not as big a venue as some of the others we've seen, but even still, it's full. Again, your typical meet and greet in AMF futsal, meets on the halfway line. They technically should be shaking hands here. That was a little bit unprofessional doing it over there, but that's just me being picky. Anyone who's new to AMF Futsal today, you can see that the referees are wearing white trousers. That tends to indicate the difference between if it's FIFA Futsal or AMF.
Con el saludo para todos, para Carlos Alberto Rodríguez que veía por ahí que está conectado a través de Facebook, está siguiendo.
I'm actually not 100% sure what these teams are, if I'm honest. But it doesn't really matter. We're just breaking down the game anyway.
Carlos Alberto Rodríguez.
Okay, guys, so who do you think is going to win? Dark blue or white and blue? I think that's white and blue anyway. Who do you think is going to win, and what do you think the score is going to be today? I'm going to go 3-2. And I'm going
to
go...
Guillermo Smith.
I'm going to go with the team that look a bit like Argentina. I might dramatically change that after a couple of minutes of watching. But I'm just going to hope they've got a little Lionel Messi in their ranks. Cody thinks Dark Blue are going to win 5-2.
Que hacemos referencia a Leandro Pinheiro. Ya están los cinco entonces. Douglas Patrón es titular. Titular Leandro Piñeiro, el 5. El 8, Moisés Ferreira.
Jackson, 5-3, red and white.
También aparece como
titular.
¿Red
and white?
Guillermo Smith. Guillermo Smith. Y también allí está parado en el círculo central conversando.
Anyway, I'm assuming Jackson means the same team as me anyway, and he said 5-3. Levi, yo, welcome to the stream, Levi. What's going on? Levi, who do you think is going to win?
Bueno, todo pronto.
And what do you think the score is going to be? Callum West, I have no idea who the better team is, but 5-3, opposite way to Jackson. Okay, so Callum West thinks the dark blues are going to win 5-3. Alejandro, 5-4, red and black. Bro, where's everyone getting these reds from? Oh, I think Alejandro looked at the goalkeeper. Okay.
Muy deportivo realmente que es Cerro Largo con un equipo
femenino
punteando también en lo que es el torneo de ascenso. Comenzó el partido. Bató recibe Alén.
What is this cameraman doing? Sort your life out.
Transita la cancha, bató a la derecha.
Jackson, no, it's green and white, just looked red.
Pide compañía.
Is it green, is it?
Edison Gómez.
Levi thinks red and black will win 6-4. Callum West, it's grey and white.
74.
I thought it was blue and white, but
repone el número
11. Either or, none of us have agreed what colour that kit is.
Piñeiro toca atrás. Patrón lo obliga.
Okay, so quite a common theme in South American AMF futsal. I've noticed they use the goalkeeper a lot. They've used the goalkeeper already.
Remata, dispara. Rebota en el capitán Moisés Ferreira.
Oh, brilliant movement. Watch this movement here. Did you see that? Outside of the boot, outside of the foot, laid it off, and a nice little cut straight into the corner of the pitch. Keep an eye out on the movement. This is what you're going to notice. The biggest difference.
El fierrito. En el fierrito.
Bro, what is this cameraman doing?
Dice que rebotó en Sebastián Merries.
Something's just happened and he missed it. Cameraman, you need to sort your life out.
Con la mano.
Okay, have a look at the creativity.
También el brasileño.
What's going on?
Adriano Baugil.
Callum West said with red numbers.
Arriba Douglas, Moisés Ferreira. Moisés. Mal respuesta, dice el árbitro del partido. Repone a Temios.
If Callum West is right and it is grey and white, that's a very
23 minutos.
Interesting kit combination.
2 minutos de partido, 0-0.
Nice little feints from the dark blue. Poor touch, but did get away with it and got a foul.
Good, good. Sobre Edison Gómez. La pitaron sobre Edison Gómez cometida por Adriano Baugil, el brasileño que defiende a este equipo de Inves 74.
Again, keep an eye. Cameraman needs a word. Yeah. Keep an eye on as well. The creativity here. So both players by the post. I'm not sure if you can see that. Blue here, blue there. And there's two people on the kick. So this is going to be interesting. I reckon he's going to move over here and he's going to come out here.
Sobre la portería de Douglas Patrón. Edison prepara la jugada. Remató. Alto, desviado.
Well, the only thing I got wrong with that is he didn't move. I really don't understand what the plan was there, to be honest. That was a bit of an odd free kick.
Ataca el Inves 74.
Okay, keep an eye on the fix, making a diagonal cut.
Peña larga. No encuentra el buen juego. El equipo de el Inves 74. La presión alta que le está haciendo a Temios. Trata de conseguir tempranamente algún gol por lo que se ve a Temios. Edison Gómez recibe.
Oh, cameraman, seriously, you need to sort out your life, mate. We're gonna watch futsal or are we just gonna watch you be a
player? Ganó Bató. Juan Martín. Alén Bató. A la derecha con Edison Gómez. La levanta, la domina Edison.
Good.
Pelota al piso.
Love the feint, love that. It's so important from a fixed.
A la derecha con Bató que recibe con pierna izquierda y domina.
Keep an eye on the movement. Brilliant feet. Nice composure on the ball as well, which is nice. Good pivot play. Laying it off to the sole.
Busca el perfil, busca rematar.
Good play from the dark blues.
Lo dice el árbitro. Buena jugada de Astemios.
If you saw the other day as well, there's loads of goals that happen like that, where the pivot lays off with the sole into the corner, the diagonal of the court, and they shoot front post and score. I'm not sure if you saw the video the other day, I can't remember who made it, but there was a futsal comparison between a few goals that have happened in futsal and what happened with Messi and Pedri from Barcelona the other day. I can't remember who Barcelona was playing, but basically Pedri and Messi did this the other day in a football game, and they were comparing it to futsal influences. Jose, welcome to the stream, buddy. I hope you're good. Again, I do like how when they're playing the fix, they are slowing the tempo down. They're fainting. Okay, that was a poor pass there, but in general, I do like it when fixed are slowing the game down. They're watching the pictures, and they're allowing the movement of the other three.
Con Santiago Irigoyte y con el capitán Leandro Piñeiro.
Keep an eye on the movement. I know the cameraman's not particularly helping us out here, but do the best you can.
I'll
tell you what, it's interesting there. I thought he gave a foul, but that would have been a penalty. Jose, I don't like the ball colour. Yeah, the ball colour could be a bit better. To be honest with you as well, the camera quality is not great, so I think it makes the ball look worse. It makes it look a bit fuzzy. Oh, love that. Great to find the parallel. Again, we've spoken about these areas before. You keeping players here and here is really going to push the opposition back. It's going to make them very nervous, and if they do try and shut you down in those areas, there's going to be a lot of gaps to appear down the middle. But obviously, of course, if you don't play it right, you could be open to a counter attack.
Uno de los árbitros no la vio el que tenía de frente, la vio el que estaba de atrás. No dan tiro de esquina.
But be able to find that parallel, the corner of the pitch.
Saque de arco que le favorece al Inbe, 74.
You need a strong hold up play. Ideally a pivot, holding the player, allowing your other players to start going into movements to try and get some sort of set move. Again, the theme that we said about South America wanting to use the keepers.
Douglas. Baugil. Sale atrás a recibir Smith.
Hang on, that's three times to the keeper.
Baugil.
So they've broken an AMF rule there. And this is a rule that we stamped out at AMF Futsal because it became very boring. Alejandro. Teams doing that all the time became very boring. Jose, the ball is very similar to the ground. Yeah, I agree.
Allí está Douglas Patrón de pierna izquierda con Adriano Baugil. A la derecha, recibe el capitán.
Good parallel again.
Se fue, no.
He's done well to hold that player. Well done.
A pierna firme fue el jugador Juan Martín Rosales.
So the white and grey, or the white and blue, whatever you want to call them, they are they're finding those parallels well so far.
Baugil va a reponer.
However, that's for possession based. Can they find the diagonals? Find people at the posts. Come on, cameraman. We can't even see the ball, man. What is going on? See, again, this is another reason AMF got rid of this rule.
Dispara! El disparo de Douglas Patrón.
Again, the reason the rule has changed, it forces the players not to be as good with movement. It ruins the game because you have to keep passing to a keeper all the time, and it slows the tempo of the game, and it kind of discredits the fact that you can only have the ball in your own half for 15 seconds. It ruined that rule, so AMF rightly had a meeting about it, and they got rid of passing back to the keeper. But that rule did come in 2019, so in this tournament, the old rule was there, which is unfortunate. I hope they don't keep using that rule, because again, sadly, we're not going to see as many show and goes here, which is a big shame, to be honest. Great movement, though.
No lo deja recibir. Este me remata Douglas.
Okay.
Se hacía allí un poco la perdía la visibilidad cuando apareció Guillermo Smith, el doloreño Mernes, pero igual se rehizo y controló el balón.
Again, keep an eye on the outside movement.
Medio, su capitán.
Right, try to go two to the post.
Allí aparece Bau Gil, Douglas Patrón. Aparece el capitán, el número 5, Piñeiro. Bien, Santiago Irigoyte.
It's definitely a tactic of theirs. They want to get two people in the top ends of the court, and they're going to use the keeper a lot.
Presiona Temios.
It's almost like using a 2-2 formation. I know they're not, but it's similar. Oh, keeper's in trouble. What color?
Y es tarjeta para Douglas Patrón. Contragolpe rápido.
What color? Temios. Yellow, I think.
Intentaba colocarla abajo, Martín Rosales.
Douglas. Okay, again. Perfect opportunity now.
Y le pitaron
to try and get a goal. Now for me, and this is just me personally now, where both teams are not dominating one another and it's quite close, I'd probably be calling a timeout now, getting a set move together and see if we can score.
Transmitiendo para Facebook, para todos aquellos amigos. Nos están siguiendo, ves el apretado saludo y el apretado abrazo.
Again as well.
Juan Martín Rosales frente al balón. Se acomoda George Juan Martín.
Who remembers the video as well where Falcao chips the keeper there?
Bató, apareció Dizo Gómez.
Oh, good save from the keeper.
Douglas Patrón. Balón al corner.
Bit more creativity needed there, I think.
Santiago Irigoyte. Balsa que Santiago arriba, Juan Martín no puede.
Oh, counter's on.
Douglas Patrón.
Slow play.
Oh,
he's done well there, to be fair.
El capitán.
Both teams
are
not quite as disciplined as other nations we've seen. That's not necessarily a bad thing, though. It would definitely be an entertaining game, I reckon, this one.
Se quedó con ese balón. Y se le quedó un poquito entreverada también la pelota.
And I'm also surprised there's not been as many games because with the discipline of both sides not being the greatest,
I'm
slightly surprised there's not been goals yet.
A la banca el 5, Juan Martín Rosales. Conversa uno de los árbitros con Douglas Patrón.
So whilst the keeper gets it,
se reanuda el partido.
Keep an eye on this space here.
16 minutos del primer tiempo, están 0-0. Final del campeonato uruguayo de fútbol de salón.
This would be space that would be occupied a lot when you can't keep going to the keeper.
Douglas Patrón.
But as I said before, because this team here are using the keeper to their advantage, they're almost kind of playing like a 2-2 formation, really.
Santiago
and instead of creating the 3 and 1 as pivot, they're kind of using the keeper as the fixed position, and it allows them to put 2
up top. Oriundo de Brasil.
Blues totally different.
Alen Bató, pelota al piso.
So let's break down Blues. So again, nice move down the middle. They're not looking to go
Walter
to the
Rodríguez.
Keeper.
Santiago Irigoyte es ese. Walter Rodríguez. Atrás. El
oh, they are. Okay.
Sebastián Mernes. Largo de Sebastián. Muy largo.
See, and this is what I'm saying about why the rule changed.
De Sebastián Mernes, pelota.
They're lacking creativity on both sides.
74.
They do a very easy rotation.
Empatando.
They do it once. They do it twice. And then bang, straight to the keeper.
0-0.
And it gives the game a totally different dynamic.
Douglas Patrón es un jugador más. Douglas presionó, bató. Bien, salió bien el Inbe, vino para Ferreira.
Oh, he's got through. Good.
Pelea Santiago. Pelea Santiago. Tony Smith.
Transition was quick there. That was nice.
Buen equipo. Bueno, por algo
again, we're looking for movement here.
No cualquiera llega,
but he's going to go back to the keeper, isn't he?
Es un muy buen equipo.
Yeah.
Experiente, parece, mucha experiencia el del Inbe 74. Pasa el saludo para la gente de Arachana que está siguiendo a través de esta emisión en Facebook.
So he's not getting a lot of movement, so again he'll bring it back to the keeper.
Douglas amaga, Douglas dispara, rebotó, le quedó al 8.
Shoot the keeper if the keeper tips it, try and tap it in.
Bien, Sebastián Mernes. Va la reposición de Moisés Ferreira. Douglas Patrón recibe en su cancha. Toca de pierna izquierda con Bau Gil. Alejandro, Adriano, Bau Gil. Adriano, Douglas, la mueve bien, la mueve muy bien. Oficio, hay oficio en este equipo. Vean cómo mueve el balón.
Oh, this game's going to be frustrating, I think, this keeper rule.
Douglas Patrón, viene Douglas, apunta, dispara. Muy desviado. Repone Temios.
Kobe, are they going to goalkeeper all the time because players aren't moving well, David, slowing the game down?
Exactly, but what I will say Gabriel Farias is at least Laura Pereira, it's showing why Machado, the new rule is so important.
Y bueno, y los que están haciendo, sumándose también a
and
los
it can make us appreciate how better
Santiago,
the players are for it.
Walter Rodriguez, el colombiano. Luche gana, la pierde ahora.
However,
Limbe, dispara.
What I do like is the transitions are very quick. Again, that would have been a rule breaker. The keeper cannot use his hands to save and then his feet to kick. You have to use your hands or you have to use your feet. You cannot use both.
Jose, I think that the rule of the pass to the goalkeeper changed now.
Yes.
I'll
let you off, Jose, because you're Spanish, but I've said that quite a few times. Yeah, it changed from 2019, and this is a game from 2018. This is part of the reason why I try and stay away from the old games, because for me, the old rule does ruin the game. Especially when it gets exploited like this. It's very similar to the poor opinion that some coaches have in FIFA of the flykeeper. If you overdo it, it can really ruin the game of futsal.
Jose,
too many passes, yeah, I agree. But again, this team are specifically putting two around the post, and they are aiming to try and kick it towards the keeper for a bobble or for them to make it difficult for the keeper to see it or whatever, but the two people are there to make themselves a nuisance. And they can only put two round that post so easily because they're using the keeper. If they couldn't use the keeper so many times, you wouldn't see two round those posts so often. However, interestingly though, the Dark Blues don't take that tactic. They've got more rotations, a bit more creativity in their play.
Desde el piso, Adriano Baugil.
But let's see who gets the first goal.
Edison Gómez obligó.
Jose, you can't do a good pressing in defense. No, it's impossible. Because at the end of the day, if you go to the keeper, it means there's a man free. And again, what they're being smart with the current rules that they had in front of them is by putting two on the post, you are forcing the Dark Blues to push back.
Sobre Douglas Patrón. La aguantó, la dominó, la llevó para acá, para allá, la empató. Abrió a la izquierda Santiago Irigoyte rápido, pero llegó tarde. Sin mala intención, la empató.
Jose, how would you want to combat this? If you were the Dark Blues and you want to go and press it, and obviously you can't, what would you do to try and stop them having two people near the post? What would you do personally? And what would the rest of you guys do? If you were Blues, Dark Blues, and you tried to combat what the keeper is currently doing on the opposition, what would you do to try and make it as hard as you can or put the opposition off from putting two round your post every time? What would you do?
Recibe Smith, Guillermo Smith. No llega Adriano Baugil. El saludo para el amigo Eduardo allá en tierras arachanas. Todos llegaron perfectamente. Gómez cruzó el balón, llegó Bató. Otra vez Gómez. Engancha Gómez. Saca el equipo del Imbe 74.
This one rule change has made futsal even more
siguiendo este partido en vivo y en directo también a todos ellos los que nos están siguiendo. El apretado abrazo y saludo grande y cordial para todos.
What it does is it just shows how small things
cerca del caño izquierdo
can change futsal, totally change it. Goals change futsal, Foul counts change futsal.
Primer tiempo. Primer final.
Tactics change futsal. Fitness.
De Soriano,
they all change capital, futsal y el dramatically, largo, and the opposition has to completely marca, change to accommodate Ferreira, that.
No hace variantes. El equipo
Jose, everyone back and let the goalkeeper kick.
Douglas Ferreira, gran contención de Douglas.
So Adriano, Jose, are you aware that they can't use their hands and their feet?
Toca atrás, Douglas la tiene. Este es Smith, este es Douglas. Avanza Douglas. La pelota venía en dirección del número 8 de Moisés Ferreira. Rebotaba en Edison Gómez.
Oh, sorry, I get what you mean now, Jose. Sorry. Smith, I understand. So you'd let everyone go back and you just let them kick it every time. But what I'm saying is, how would you combat that to stop that happening in future? Because obviously what you can't let them do is just constantly have possession all throughout the game. So what would you do to try and prevent them thinking that that's an advantage? Just put an advert quickly because it's just on a quick timeout. So guys, this will give you you must let them pass back. Sorry, Jose, I'm not making myself clear. What I mean is you cannot shut them down. I get that. But what would you do if you were the manager? What would you do to make them not think that that's a good tactic? What could you do I'm trying to say it in a way that you'd understand. To basically counteract what they're trying to do. What would you do to counter that tactic that they're currently using?
El saludo para Benjamín Hornos. El saludo para Benjamín Horno también. Ya está grande y tiene.
Does any of you have any good ideas of how you would combat that?
Jackson,
press high so they worry that they panic high press and hopefully get a goal from him wasting the ball. Jackson, the issue you have with that is if you high press the goalkeeper, you've got players free. So there's nothing stopping the keeper shooting as he is, and there's nothing stopping the keeper chipping it out to the wings or up top. Oh, he missed. Jose, yes. If you were managing the Dark Blues, what would you do to counter what the opposition are doing with their goalkeeper? You have to have a plan to counteract what they're trying to do.
Jackson, make them give the ball away and then confidence goes and they stop doing it and for the rest of the game press. I don't quite agree with you, Jackson. I will go into that in a minute. Jose, I think they are doing well. I agree,
Capitán Piñeiro,
but for me,
Douglas, Adriano, Baufil,
I think
Douglas,
for me, there's not
Douglas,
enough
busca la portería, disparo Douglas.
To counter
no hay buena
to counter what
Douglas,
the opposition are doing.
Todavía.
So, if the cameraman Santiago helps, I will tell you what I would
final,
do.
Campeonato Uruguayo, fútbol de salón. 12 minutos del primer tiempo.
So again,
0-0.
Really good movement from the Dark Blues, passing it, waiting, but is it effective? Can they break lines? Can they kill their defence? A waste of possession for me. Okay, so now they've got it, we know it's going to go to their player, and we know it's going to go back to the keeper, so let's break this down. So they've got someone on the ball, back to the keeper, now they're going to put two on the goalpost. For me, you have got to put, I'm just going to stop it just there, they'll have a player here, and you need a dark blue in front, and a dark blue in front. The goalkeeper shouldn't, in theory, be scoring from his own goalpost to score in this goalpost. For me, If the keeper gets a hand on it, he needs to push it forward. As he pushes it forward, these two dark blues can go on the counter. And for me, that is what you have to use as a weakness to this and this, trying to be here and to try and be there or anything around these areas. Because if he pushes into this space here, these two can start driving and hopefully you'll be able to use the transitions of futsal, what's, you know, happens in the game a hell of a lot. But you have to counter what they are trying to do. If they're trying to play long and play really offensive, then fine. Soak it up, but you have to be able to counter-attack fast. And if you counter-attack fast, you need to go with numbers. Of course, you need balance, but they will be totally outnumbered by having two up the pitch.
Aparece el jugador Adriano. Otra vez
aparece Adriano. Bougil. Ale mató, le pone velocidad dinámica al juego. Rebota en el capitán Piñero. Walter Rodríguez, Santiago. Therefore, making Santiago. An interception.
No puede Bató. Vino para Ferreira, falta sobre Moisés Ferreira.
Split the passes from the go to the wide defenders, meaning they can only go forward where you can split the ball.
Gómez.
Yes, but that's pretty much what they're doing, Callum. But
Raúl Flores,
if you open up the middle,
saludos, ojito,
the keeper will just keep shooting, which is fine, because then that will then go into what I would do to counter that. As the keeper shoots, I'd want both my players in front of the players that are near the post, and the keeper needs to be pushing the ball down for the players to then go on the counter.
Adriano,
Callum, I meant high attackers on the byline, where I said defenders.
Guillermo,
yes, but you can't have both, Callum, you can't have both at the same time going like this, because if you go both like this, you can go down the middle and then you've got two people out of the game. You can have one go and press and one slightly in the diag, because if they do go in the middle, that player can recover. But if they both go out wide, they're both out of the game if it goes down the middle. Again, futsal's like chess. Whatever you do, there has to be a consequence. And this is what I'm saying, by the goalkeeper kicking it long, we have to find a consequence to their actions. What could be the negative or their weakness from constantly kicking it long? And the obvious one would be it's hard to score like that, but they're opening themselves up by putting two people up the pitch to counter-attacks. So we need to put plans into place that will allow us to counter-attack their tactic.
Se va Santiago, llegó el capitán Piñeiro. Ahora Smith, antes llegó Sebastián Márquez. Santiago Irigoyte, atrás Walter Rodríguez, el coloniense la tiene al piso. El saludo también para la familia de Walter en Colonia. Ahí va Len, engancha Len.
Brilliant feint.
Sale atrás, lo presiona en la marca.
He's done well to recover that. He made a mistake, but he's done well. Good. Fantastic work. Really aggressive from both teams as well.
Really good commitment from both teams. Jose, lucky that now you can pass the goalkeeper more than once.
Exactly.
La gran parcialidad de Temios.
Well, unless it's a throw-in.
De Liga Santa de Praga.
Allá lo vemos. Throw-ins don't count as the pass count.
De la Liga del Futsal, Walter Rodríguez. Vino para Walter Rodríguez. El señor Rafael Álvarez. Al señor Raúl Morosini. Al intendente Agustín Bascú. Lo vemos allá instalados debajo de una bandera.
The only thing I would say, Jose, at least what this does is it allows us to break these games down more and talk tactics of how you counteract this.
Y Botana estará tranquilo allá mirando en su cerro largo natal, con la tele, con la compu, con el teléfono. ¡Va el disparo! La tiene Irigoyte.
There you go. See, counter, go. Gotta be quick, gotta be quick.
Santiago, este es Edison Gómez. La tiene el piso. Vino con Santiago Irigoyte. Amaga Santiago. Va a buscar el disparo. Sacó el disparo. Desviado. El disparo Santiago Irigoyte. Colmado. Es el mundialista Alberto de la Santa de Praga.
Alejandro.
Primer final, campeonato uruguayo de fútbol de salón.
They should play three moves ahead of the opponent when they see a trigger from the other team. That's when they react such as when the goalkeeper makes a trigger move, then you should close the center. Jose, next Sunday I will talk about the rules in my seminary.
Un encontronazo casual de Bauxil con Bató. El capitán Piñeiro. El 5, vino largo. Cabezazo. Smith. ¡Ay, Smith! ¡Ay, Smith! ¡Ay, Smith! ¿Qué me hiciste, Smith?
Yeah, Jose, is that seminar going to be in English or is it going to be in Spanish?
Inve 74 y vean dónde va a reponer Artemios.
Alejandro, I'm just going to go back to your point. They should plan three moves ahead of the opponent. Doing that instinctively is quite hard, Alejandro, to be fair. But I do understand what you're saying. That's a bad foul. When they see a trigger from the other team, that's when they react, such as when the goalkeeper makes a trigger move, then you should close the center. Yes, well, this is kind of what I'm saying about if that's the way that they want to play. When you had the timeout a minute ago, I'd have been putting in place a plan to counteract the fact that they keep playing to the goalkeeper. Because at this moment in time, you cannot stop the goalkeeper taking shots, but that's fine. Because do you want a player shooting in the final third, or do you want them to shoot in the first third? It's obvious you want them to shoot in their own half or in the first third. That shouldn't be too much danger for us. With a good goalkeeper, you should expect that goal shouldn't go in. But what we have to have is a counter-attack plan. So when the keeper does save it and he hasn't, you know, missed the target or done it so well that we've had to give out for a corner, we should be able to counter-attack where the keeper is pushing it towards forward motions so we can go on the counter to score.
El saludo, bueno, Gastón, que me hace la seña.
Jose, thank you for letting me know. I assumed it was Spanish, that's why I didn't
el capitán Piñeiro,
look too much into it, but it looks really good from the Spanish Federation.
Vino con Piñeiro, Leandro, la pone al piso, aguanta, busca llegar a la línea final, ¿no? Antes Walter Rodríguez, rebota en Piñeiro, repone Artemios. Jorge Núñez, que vino al campo, al rectángulo, jugador de mil batallas con este equipo de Artemios. ¿Cuánta historia? ¿Cuántos partidos importantes de Jorge en este escenario deportivo? ¿Cuántos títulos de Artemios desde que llegó? Más de 20 años defendiendo estos colores. El abrazo para todos.
Aquí estamos, desde
Alberto de la Santa, de lo más alto de la tribuna. Bató, se le queda un poquito atrás, la aguanta Bató, la pierna.
Yes, Josie, I did see that, but I couldn't.
Vino para
el I didn't jugador, bother in the end because I knew it would be in Spanish.
Adriano Baugil.
It does look good though. The poster looked nice, and I know Alex gets quite a lot of good people involved, so
I knew it
would be good. It's just sad that I wouldn't understand what everyone was saying.
Smith se le va fuera. Repone Artemios.
That's got to be one of the first times I've seen them actually make a run forward instead of passing to the keeper. If he pulled that off, that would have been good.
11 de la mañana hasta las 13:30. Fue mucho el agua que cayó aquí en la capital departamental, pero después, por suerte, la tarde no tuvimos inclemencia del tiempo.
Unlucky.
Piñeiro, la aguanta, va todo.
Here we go. Batón, good save.
Penal. Reclaman penal. Reclaman
count
penal.
Count is on.
Cobra el árbitro. El disparo llegaba a Smith.
Good defense.
Arriba le dice el árbitro. Arriba le dice a Smith. Arriba Smith. Arriba Smith.
Alejandro translate.
Se vuelven locos los parciales de Artemios. Ale Bató, velocidad de Bató.
I'll tell you what, both teams are very, very aggressive, aren't they? Very streetwise. Great movement. That cut to the outside allowed that cut inside with the ball.
17 minutos, primer tiempo, 0-0. Ale Bató, la engancha.
Just for that split second, that movement allowed that to happen.
Jorge Núñez.
Oh, great movement.
Guillermo Smith.
He disguised the pass to the Adriano. Fix in order to play out wide. Love
Baugil.
That.
Rebota en Bató.
Callum West has regretted his 5-3 prediction.
Douglas Patron.
Callum, trust me, this is a final.
Patron.
Second half is when it will get interesting.
La tiene Guillermo. Va a sacar el zurdazo.
Every game we've watched, second half goals happen.
Número 11, Guillermo Smith. No ha hecho variantes.
So even though I would be regretting it myself, I still wouldn't rule it out. You just don't know with finals.
No puede recibir bien, Civitate. Leandro Piñeiro pierde con Jorge Núñez. La aguanta Jorge. Sale atrás. Sebastián Mernies, largo el balón, ha presionado en la marca por Moisés Ferreira.
I think again, this is another reason why I always get us to watch youth games, women's games, adults games, different countries, different abilities. Because what we need to do is always be critical of the games and see what we can learn. And yes, okay, this isn't a rule anymore, but it still gives us the time to be critical and break down games and see the games for what they are and see how we adapt. Because if our futsal knowledge is going to improve, we need to be in game action and be able to think about the overall picture and see how we can change games.
Matías Álvarez, no le entendí bien, Matías.
It would just be a lot easier if the cameraman sorted his life out.
Douglas, dispara Douglas, May Sebastián a media, le quedó a Piñeiro. El disparo de Leandro, el capitán se va desviado. Repone a Temio.
Jackson, same score for different teams.
Saludo también a Ay, la el equipo dime va para
Yeah, so basically this is an AMF futsal game, it's not a FIFA game. There's two different rules. However, this is an outdated rule of AMF. So, for example, you are not allowed to play it back to the goalkeeper unlimited amount of times. However, what I will try and do is tell you a few of the rules that will help. You cannot keep the ball in your half for more than 15 seconds. That helps to promote more of an attacking game. My issue with the FIFA version is you can play brilliant possession. There's no... Let's say you're winning 4-1. Someone posted a clip on Grown Futsal on Facebook, the group I set up, and someone shared a brilliant possession video from Barcelona. They're 4-1 up, and all they're interested to do is pass it in their own half. Now, for the spectator, that can just ruin the game and be boring. We want action, we want things to happen. So to be able to only play in your half 15 seconds, you're forcing to go forward. And yeah, of course, if you go into the attack and half and you come back, then you're 15 seconds resets again. But it's to encourage you to be attacking. There's no fly goalkeepers, and it's throw-ins. And that includes corners. Corners and throw-ins are throw-ins, and they're not kick-ins. Which, again, creates a lot of time to do different types of tactics, and it can create a lot of goal-scoring opportunities.
Están saludando, bueno, el apretado abrazo para todos ellos. Y a lo que a través de Ruta 21.
Jackson
YouTube,
said he can't see 8 goals
YouTube,
going in from here.
Están siguiendo también este trabajo. El apretado abrazo para todos ellos. Y a lo que a través de YouTube después nos van a ver mañana, pasado, un día de estos.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying. And I also do like teams keeping the ball. But there's keeping the ball and there's keeping the ball with purpose. So, for example, if you watch Man City, Barcelona play football, they're keeping the ball brilliantly and there's a purpose to it. Or there's some teams that get the ball, they're in midfield, they should play forward, they turn around, they play back to the goalkeeper. You know, there's two sets of possession. And like I said, the 15-second rule, you can still, you know, 15 seconds is still quite a long time in futsal. But it's forcing you to have a bit more purpose in your possession. And of course, you can keep possession for as long as you can in the attacking half. But it's forcing you to be more attacking rather than just possession or defensive based.
Y también para Carlos Joaquín Balbé. Bien, un abrazo a Carlos Hornos, dice el amigo Carlos Balbé. Xavier Civitate, el fraventino, el jugador de Anglo. El dordeño recibió, lo anticiparon.
You won't get the best game tonight, though, in regards to a real AMF game, because, as we discussed later in the video, because they can pass the goalkeeper as many times as they can, you're not going to see the show and goes, the fixed go and show. All these different movements that we're used to seeing in futsal, we're not going to see tonight, unfortunately. However, What we do want to do today is break down the game and say, okay, tactics-wise, what would we do different? How would we counteract this? Because I think having that intellectual knowledge of game understanding and everything else, we need that. And especially the fact that we can't play. We need that little bit of a little bit of excitement in our lives, breaking down games and stuff. And also as well, because this is Twitch, we can have people click on it any time and they've never seen futsal at all. And hopefully more people will see it. Callum, an example of no purpose is England's international football, because they keep the ball with no purpose and continue to go backwards all the time. Yes. Yes. And even when we create players that do like to keep the ball, but with purpose, they don't tend to play them as often. Están 0-0. 36 segundos finales. But yeah, no, you're spot on with England. It used to annoy me all the time. You have so many centre midfielders, they just want to pass back all the time. And yes, of course, you do need to play back in order to go forward sometimes, but with England, it was just safety, safety, safety all the time. It's so frustrating to watch. Yeah, so this is a Uruguay final from 2018. And the new AMF rules came out in 2019, so that's why these rules are outdated. And it's not until we've gone back to the old way we can appreciate how much better AMF football is now up to what it used to be. Because you can clearly see both teams can play, they're very aggressive and you know, they're extremely fit, they know what they're doing, but the old rules is making it too easy to play boring, ineffective futsal. And especially with it being a final as well, they desperately don't want to give away that first goal. The first goal in this game is going to be very important, I think. Also as well, what we try and do on this channel is I try and separate throughout the week watching youth, female and men, and even amongst that we try and watch different countries, different abilities, different standards in regards to, like, you know, like the highest tier, the lowest tier, because for us this channel is not about just playing all the best matches and going, oh my god, look how amazing this is. It's a learning experience. We want to talk about futsal as a whole, and what's good about the game, what's bad about the game, and we can start comparing. So for example, we watched Switzerland women. They weren't particularly great, up to Colombia women, who were amazing, and then we compared them to the blokes, and even though Colombia was good, they weren't quite up to some of the highest men that we saw, and it was really nice to compare why that was. And a lot of the themes that we've been seeing with youth and female up to men is movement off the ball, which is a shame that we've not had that today because of this old rule. But what is nice is just watching different standards and giving females a platform, youth a platform, and men a platform. We can critique, we can learn, and yeah, and that's what this channel is about, really. It's not just about looking good all the time, and unfortunately that's what some channels try and do. They put too much emphasis on, yes, this looks cool, this is going to make me look good, but we're not really bothered about that. It's all about education, it's all about giving different countries and all the different categories of platform. I'm really excited as well, actually. This week is going to be the first time we're going to have the country Taiwan on this channel, and that will be on Friday, I think. So we've had so many different countries on this channel already, and Taiwan will be the first time they will be on. They'll be on this channel. I am gonna skip this. I'll tell you what. Oh yeah, bust out the moves. By the way, this is something that I'm planning for GB. By the way. I've spoken to some acting schools, I've spoken to some dance schools, that when we do internationals, this is something that I want to create at halftime as well. I think if you are going to attract a crowd to want to come to futsal, there has to be more than just futsal. We have to have a whole package. You see that girl, she's way out of time. Keep watching her, she's watching everyone else. Bruh, she's literally just learnt this thing. How long is halftime typically? I think it's 15 minutes, but again, it could be different. But I'm going to try and skip this. I don't think this is 15 minutes. Actually, it might be 10. What's this about? I still find that girl really funny. She didn't know what she was doing. She kept looking around. I don't want to skip too far. Oh look, get the mascots out. Woo! I don't want to skip too far when you miss the start of the game. Oh, now they got the kids playing. Get in. See, now when I first got involved in futsal with Bristol City, that's what I used to love, was taking the mascots to go and watch Bristol City futsal men's. Not the most exciting team to watch, I must admit, but the mascot stuff is brilliant. Is Enrique going to be coach of the GB team? Yes, he is. Yeah, Enrique came to the C13 World Cup with us. It was me and Enrique that coached and managed. But Enrique is the men's manager, yeah. That was one of the first things I did when I was president. I sacked myself as manager because I was hired as manager before I became president. And then as I became president, I sacked myself and brought in Enrique.
Ese es Bato. Juan recibe Dinson Gómez. Engancha Gómez. Va a sacar el disparo. O sea, ¡gol! ¡Disparo!
Dark Blues got to that post. Unlucky.
No pudo entrarle el balón.
Yeah, thank you very much. You know, I know he is. To be honest, he was my number one target and I was absolutely gobsmacked when I got him. I'm not going to lie. Absolutely gobsmacked. And to be fair, I spoke to a few other good coaches about getting involved in GB. And slowly started to get somewhere. But it's always quite difficult because there is a little bit of politics between FIFA and AMF, which sometimes can get in the way. But having good people like Enrique involved just makes it really good because, again, for me, I'm more about quality over quantity. And having someone like Enrique will offer a lot of knowledge for players. And hopefully it'll attract a lot of players to want to get involved as well. Callum, are we going to be... Are you going to be managing as well? Yeah, so the thing is, me and Enrique talk about it a lot anyway. So when it comes to the men's, it will most likely be, it will be driven by Enrique. My main objective is to be getting a coaching staff across all the age groups to get them involved. Because obviously... For me, I'm involved in Bristol Futsal as well, and as I said to you, Callum, that I'm trying to set up a men's team for Bristol Futsal in the long term. But what I don't want to do is spread myself too thin. So having people like Enrique involved will be massive for GB Futsal, and it will give you guys a hell of a lot of knowledge. And diversity is massive as well. So he will have a Spanish background, I'll obviously have an English background, and I want to get more people involved from different backgrounds. That's why I speak to a lot of coaches. I've spoken to Marquinhos y Xavier from Brazil a lot, Zigo, who was the creator of the 4-0, Andre Cairo, who posts a lot of YouTube videos. He was based in Australia, but he's Brazilian, and he's now in Dubai. So loads of people. Oh, it's an own goal! No, Callum, you haven't. 1-0! So, foreigners can play if you've got a British passport, which kind of probably sounds like I've just contradicted myself. But say, for example, if you're Italian but you have a British passport, you can play. It's all based upon passports, basically. However, even if you haven't got a British passport, there are opportunities like Champions Leagues and things like that. Jackson, do you regret that, or do you think it was the right decision? Jackson, what do you mean? What do I regret?
Sebastián Mernes recibe Alem Bató. Lo presiona la marca Guillermo Smith. Jorge Núñez. Lo anticipan. Smith la pierde. Le ganó Bató. Sale velocidad Alem. Engancha Alem. Tienta esa paloma.
Cameraman, suit your life out. Calle, remember what I said about goals? Goals change games. I've just got a feeling this is going to be a bit more of a feisty game. Now that first goal has gone in, I cannot help but think more goals are going to go in now. I might be wrong, but yeah. Jackson said, do I regret sacking myself as coach manager for GB? No, I don't. The reason I don't is if you are going to steer the ship in the right way, the first thing you cannot have is too big of an ego. And GB cannot be ran just by one person. And sometimes you just have to be honest with yourself. Like, I'm 27. If my body wasn't totally ruined because of my ankle, I would probably be still playing futsal or football. So I've got a lot to learn, and for me personally, whilst I've got the opportunity of being able to sack myself and bring in someone like Enrique, I'd like to learn from him in my early stages of futsal. I also have to be honest to the fact that I believe Enrique is a better futsal coach than me. So I've never hid that fact either, and I'm pretty sure 99.9% or 100% people will agree that Enrique is a better futsal coach than me, so I have to be honest and say, if I can get a better person for the job, I want to get a better person for the job, so it's a no-brainer for me. And also as well, what's nice is Enrique still wants me to be a coach with him and help him out as well, so it's not a case of I've just sacked myself and now I'm not involved at all. I'll still have a massive influence, but what I can do is guide GB in the way that I want, and having someone like Enrique
would be massive. How long to get a
British passport? 5 years. Not sure, to be honest. Originally I thought it was 3, but I'm not 100% sure. It depends on the application process, but if you know Lucas Totti, who plays for Helvetia, he was going through that process, so I'm not sure if he's finalised it or not, but it might be worth having a discussion with him if you know him.
Excelente marco de público ha llegado para esta gran final del futsal entre los astemios, el campeón mercedario que hace pocos días atrás lograba el ascenso. Un año no participó, les cuento a los amigos que no están en la ciudad, un año no participó del torneo del futsal local. Acá se juega futsal, no es fútbol de salón, se juega futsal. Un año no participó y volvió a la liga este año en los astemios y debió participar en la divisional B. Eso hizo que hiciera un excelente campeonato y lograra el título frente al Rojo el pasado domingo. El próximo año militarán en primera división. Xavier Civitate vino al reclamo. Edison Gómez. Presiona Astemios, no puede salir claro el equipo del Imbe. Lo presionaban al capitán Leandro Piñeiro.
Es like an interview. I never played futsal because basically in my area in Bristol, when I grew up playing football, there was no futsal for me to play, and sadly I couldn't play properly after the age of 14-15 because I had a career-ending injury. So basically I was at Cardiff City. And I had to basically give up playing. I attempted to try and play, even though the doctor said that, you know, I'd never play professional again. I would constantly get injured all the time. So I ignored that. I joined Yeovil. I eventually quit because I just wasn't enjoying it. And to be fair, their facilities and stuff was rubbish. That's okay. And then, yeah, so I went to college. I played a few semi-pro games and got paid, and then just kept getting injured all the time, to be honest, and got fed up with it. So and also I was coaching at the same time, so the moment I got injured I made a decision that I wanted to coach, because it was something that I wanted to do when I stopped playing anyway. To be honest, I still think I could probably play futsal, but I would have to get massively fit.
Xavier Civita te recibe a la derecha con Juan Martín Rosales.
How did I get injured? Okay.
Alexandro Douglas.
So I'm not very proud of what we're about to say. So please don't think for 1 minute I'm showcasing bad behaviour, but basically I wasn't very well behaved in school. I kind of had the attitude that, yes, I'm going to be a professional footballer. I was told all my life I was going to be a professional footballer. So played for Cardiff, and I was told that I could have the day off, and I went, no, I need to change my behaviour at school. So I decided to go into school. Started mucking about on the Astro, and as I went for a header, one of my mates was still mucking about and he pushed me and my ankle twisted the wrong way.
Mernes, va el pelotazo, demasiado largo, venía para Jorge
Núñez. So, one day I tried to be good at school.
Moisés, le queda a Leandro Piñero.
I got injured.
El que viene acá es Adriano Baugil, el brasileño.
Also, to answer, we've already done Argentina and Brazil.
El capitán Piñeiro, Douglas Patrón, Moisés Ferreira, Douglas Patrón, la tiene Douglas, Moisés, no, Douglas, de izquierda, toca con el capitán Piñeiro, busca el claro, va Douglas, disparó, rebotó en Juan Martín, viene a velocidad, muy largo se le fue al Embató. Sale Nimbe, abajo Juan Martín Rosales, ante la marca de Piñeiro.
I must admit though, I am totally, totally gutted that futsal wasn't around when I played. Because I absolutely loved it, and to be honest, I was massively, massively influenced. In the last 2 years or so before I got injured, I was massively, massively influenced by Ronaldinho.
Enfría el partido, la tiene Douglas. Mira el arco, va a disparar, no. Ay.
Se equivocó. I got up to doing like 5,000 kick-ups. We'd do kick-ups to the shops and back. I would train 3 hours a day. On top of any other training that I had. So even if I had a training session, I would still make sure I did my own personal 3 hour session a day. Whether that was, and it used to be a mixture of different things, like dribbling out of cones, long distance passing, where I'd get, you know, like when you do like the summer running, like races and stuff, I'd get my mate to stand in one of those and I'd have to try and keep it in the small area where I'd ping it across. Both feet, shooting practice, shuttle runs, every session I'd be like, oh, do you know what, I'm just going to get out of the way, I hate it. Jackson, what countries play in the Kids World Cup? Like obviously Paraguay and stuff. So obviously it depends on what World Cup you're in, mate. But in the World Cup that we were just in, it was in Group A was India, Italy, Brazil, Argentina. In our group it was Paraguay, Colombia, Switzerland, and us, GB. And then in the other group it was South Africa, Catalonia, which is they want their independence based in Spain. South Africa, Catalonia, Australia, and France. Yeah. And our games that we played, we played Colombia, Switzerland, Paraguay, Switzerland, France. Fun fact for everybody, there hasn't ever been a youth tournament that we've participated in that we've not played Switzerland twice. We did a tournament in Italy and a tournament in the World Cup, and both times we had to play Switzerland twice. Oh yeah, we had the hardest group. Absolutely gutted. Like, we were basically better than every single team in the third group. Catalonia, South Africa, Australia, and France. And I think we had beat Argentina and Italy. And India, obviously. Because they got hammered by everybody. It was pretty much only Brazil and Paraguay that I generally thought was better than us. Because even Colombia, we beat them in the second half after we kind of got the first initial nerves out of our system. And we were a lot better than Colombia as well, because, as I've said in other streams, we had 8 9-meter penalties. And we only scored 2 or 3 of them. And if we scored all of them, even with the bad start that we had, we would have won. But when you're playing with kids sometimes, especially people that are not used to taking 9-meter penalties as well, using the toe is not something that they particularly do. So trying to do an inside foot or a laces shot, especially for youth, can make it a lot easier for goalkeepers to save it. But again, that's the beauty of doing international tournaments. You learn a lot when you're out there. You learn a lot about your players, because there are players that do very well in training, they do very well in trials, do very well in friendly games, and when it comes to a World Cup is when you kind of get to know who's your really good players, who can deal with who can deal with the stress, who can deal with the... good save! Who can deal with the competitiveness, who can recover after games quickly, because remember as well, games come back to back to back. Like, we are playing one game per day. And I think what people don't understand, unless you've been in a tournament, is you can get physically tired by being mentally tired. So what I had to try and find a good balance between when we were out there was how much fun the kids would have when they're not playing. So we went to the pool, we were doing kick-up challenges, and if you dropped the ball, you had to go in the swimming pool, and it was freezing, there was no heaters in the swimming pool. So it was like a punishment having to go for a swim. We go to the beach and we do some stretching, and some of them did wrestling in the sea and stuff. Here we go, counters on! Jackson said that would be unreal if you would reverse. I think you mean it would be unreal if we could do our own international tournament. We will, and there is plans for it. Jackson, actually, I've got a poster that I'm going to send your dad after this stream. There's going to be a futsal cup called the Sardinia Futsal Cup. He came on our stream the other day, called Luigi. He's going to be doing an AMF tournament for adults, men and women, and he's also going to do a under 11, 13, 15 tournament as well. So hopefully we might be able to get some teams in for that as well. And I want to do some tournaments at Gloucester University, which is the home of GB. With a 1,100 capacity stadium, and hopefully get loads of countries around the world, because like I said, I set up a WhatsApp group, and there's loads of different nationalities in there that want to play international futsal. Would I be C16 now? I think so. I'll have to double check, Callum. Because technically, it depends on what AMF say, basically. Because in theory, yes, you're C16 now, but they keep calling the last World Cup C15. So I think they might still clash with C15 just because that tournament was postponed. But yes, you are C16 in theory. So if it wasn't for the pandemic, you would 100% be C16. But what I'm saying is they might keep you as C15 to make up for the tournament they didn't make. That didn't happen.
El equipo del Inbe 74 no ha hecho variantes. Los mismos cinco que ingresaron jugando, cuando estamos en 10 minutos del segundo tiempo, se mantienen los cinco jugando todavía. Irigoyte, Santiago, amaga Santiago. Busca el centro de la cancha a la izquierda, vino con Santiago, despierna izquierda. Arriba el disparo.
Callum
Santiago,
as well, I think you are right about being nervous about your scoreline prediction.
Recibe Santiago largo para el jugador Moisés Ferreira. Venía la pelota de Guillermo Smith. Vaya el apretado abrazo, vuelvo a reiterar a que nos apoyaron. A los que los molestábamos, nos dijeron que sí. Adriano, busca la línea final, Adriano, Santiago Irigoyte. Baujil, Adriano, el que buscaba desbordar. Repleto de público el Praga.
Levi, ¿estás todavía con nosotros?
Final del Campeonato Uruguayo de Fútbol de Salón. Astemios, representando el fútbol de nuestra ciudad, el fútbol de Salón. Recibiendo al Inbe de Cerro Largo de 33.
Kobe, are you still watching?
Piñeiro, Leandro.
To be fair, Douglas, Kobe's patrón, not, I understand.
Apunta
he's,
Douglas, he's, dispara Douglas, ay que cerca.
He's one of the young ones.
Rebotó en un jugador o en el pie del arquero de Astemios, exacto del costado de esquina con la mano que respondrá.
Oh,
el Inbe 74.
H. Kembry.
Moisés Ferreira, va largo el envío.
Oh,
Moisés, golpe
message.
Cabeza de Alem Bató afuera, repone el Inbe. 74. Nos han hecho saber que el Inbe es un barrio allá en las tierras arachanas. El saludo a los de ese barrio que nos están siguiendo.
At the beginning I was like, it will be like 1-0 or 2-1, but then I remembered it's a final, so I changed it.
Que tiene,
to be honest, Callum, that's more reason for it to be a lower scoreline, isn't it? Most teams play a bit more conservative and they're worried about losing in the final.
Que está, muy bien posicionado, hoy se tuvo que suspender el partido por las fuertes inclemencias del tiempo.
Brilliant movement from the middle, did you see that, guys?
Antes llegaba, robó, ese es el Jorge Smith. Adriano Smith.
Oh, love that. Goal! Game back on! Boom!
Del Inbe 74, Guillermo Smith.
Alejandro, sorry, I couldn't comment, my battery ran out. No worries, Alejandro.
It's
1-1 now, game on! What do we reckon, guys? Do you reckon this will go to extra time tonight? Imagine if it's 2-2 and it goes to extra time and then someone wins 3-2. Does that technically mean I've
Santiago Irigoyte, balón afuera. Moisés Ferreira.
Does my score prediction only count if it's in normal time, or will it count if it goes to extra time?
Se frena Douglas.
That's the only possible way I think
para
it could be 3-2.
Oh! Qué gol que malogró.
Bruh.
Qué gol que malogró Guillermo Smith.
Jackson said it'll count. I'll take it, Jackson. I'll take it.
Arriba.
Again, goals change games. Look how the game's changed. Oh, brilliant play by the pivot. Great defending as well. Okay, this game's starting to heat up now, which is nice. Great movement from this blue. Nice little blocks. Is there going to be... There's definitely something between these two. Keep an eye on it.
1-1, Gómez, Santiago Irigoyte, la domina Santiago.
Keep an eye.
Intenta zafar, saca Inbe
74. Good defended in the end.
Adriano,
this game has totally changed now.
Douglas Patron.
Both teams want to win.
La viene a buscar.
They can smell the cut now.
Ferreira, Douglas Patron. Ahí va Douglas avanzando la cancha.
Oh, brilliant movement. Did you see that show and go? That's what we want to see. And when you can't keep using the keeper, that's what we'd have seen a lot more.
Oh,
he didn't mean it, but it is a bad challenge. I can't believe he didn't get a card for that. Bruh, how did he not get a card for that?
miramos y recorremos con la mirada el costado de la cancha y encontramos gente del fútbol, cantidad, que mañana no van a entrar a sus equipos. Y bueno, que han venido a ver el futsal hoy, o el fútbol de salón. Gómez, la aguanta Gómez. Trastavilla Gómez.
Good hold up play.
Final Gómez, la línea final.
Okay, this is where the creativity comes in. What do you reckon?
Muy buen jugador este brasileño,
How creative do you reckon this is going to be? It's going to have to be. Watch this player here. Watch this player here. Oh, that's so poor.
Se consumió el tiempo, bola que le corresponde al Inbe 74.
For me, there's got to be an absolute standard. When you're working on throw-ins or corners, you should be saying, look, this is the minimum that I expect you to do. Keep doing this, keep doing this. Whatever that plan is, as the basic of if you run out of ideas, do that. Whether if it's just two players that just swap, at least it's something. And then, if the players can think of some creative ideas you've been working on in training, have a quick chat. Yeah, let's try that one. And if they can, at the very least, you've got a set way of doing a corner that creates a goal score opportunity.
Saque de costado, al tiro de esquina, a la reposición del costado de la punta de la cancha.
That, what just happened from that last throw-in, is down to lack of
Martín Sánchez.
Creativity, lack of planning, a lack of structure. Well, there's been a timeout. 8 minutes left, guys. 8 minutes left. If that clock is to be trusted. And if that is also to be trusted, that's a 2,000 each, I think. That might be totally random. Can that honestly be 8 minutes left? That seems like a long time.
Adriano Baugil. Disparo que se va arriba. Tanteador que se mantiene en igualdad 1-1 en la primer final del Campeonato Uruguayo de Fútbol de Salón. Estadio repleto en el mundialista Alberto Delia Santa de Praga, de la ciudad de Mercedes. Entrando el partido Inbe 74 de Cerro Largo y Astemios de Soriano, capital. Adriano, Dulas, ahí avanza Dulas con el balón. Metros que la tiene para llevarla a la pelota. Mira el arco, dispara Walter Rodríguez. Rebota ese balón en la pierna derecha. Repone el Inbe por intermedio de Moisés Ferreira. Dulas Patrón. Mira el arco, mira compañía. Se mueven sus compañeros. A la derecha con el capitán Leandro Piñeiro. Dulas.
Oh, he's done well. Counters on.
¡Disparo!
A goal! What a goal that is.
Golazo del Inbe 74. Golazo.
De Guillermo. What a goal that is.
Sacó el latigazo, nada que hacer para el arquero. Sebastián
Mernes. What?
Y aquí gana la visita, gana el Inbe
74. Oh, that was unreal.
Por 2-1. El autor del gol, el número 11, Guillermo Smith.
Because my phone's slightly more delayed. I was kind of hoping to Mernes. See that back.
Civitate.
Oh, that was a beauty. Jose, big mistake of the blue player.
El zurdazo. Dispara Guillermo Smith. Rebota en Guillermo Smith.
What a goal. What is the keeper doing? Yeah, I totally agree, Jose. It was a big mistake. You cannot be allowing anyone to have that amount of space when it comes to shooting. You have to be compact. You have to have your defensive lines in place. Create those traps and get that ball back. And that did not happen. But take nothing away from the strike, but the attacker. That was an unreal finish.
Zurdo. Lindo gol, un verdadero golazo. Con que pasó el Inbe 74.
He permitted the counter-attack. Yeah, I totally agree.
Guillermo Smith. Dulas Patrón. Ahí va Douglas. Mira el arco, Douglas. Dispara Douglas.
I was saying before, Jose, one of the biggest standouts that people don't talk about enough for me is when you look at the very, very highest level of futsal, is how quickly, when they lose the ball, how they are so quick to get the ball back. Like, if they even think for a second they've lost the ball, they slide tackle the person to get the ball off the pitch, because they're just they just cannot be countered like that just happened there.
Civitate. Cerrado el equipo visitante. Buena presencia en la defensiva.
To be honest, the whites pretty much did what I said the dark blues needed to do in the first half. They needed to focus on counters and fast counterattacks.
La pelota vino para Mernes. Irigoyte, Santiago. A la izquierda con Walter Rodríguez.
It's better from the Blues.
Y ahora se cierra el equipo.
They've kind of slowed the tempo down a little bit, which is a bit concerning, because we want the Dark Blues to get back in this game to make a game of it, and obviously I want it to be 3-2. But the Dark Blues seem to have been affected by this goal in a negative way.
Encuentra compañía en el capitán.
Jackson, I'm looking forward to training with you again, gutted on Tuesday when it wasn't on.
I know, to be fair, Jackson, I did message your dad saying, look, I've been told that we're pretty much going to be going into lockdown on the Tuesday. Would he like to come with the older lot on a Monday just for one last session, because we were doing a shoot and practice game? But obviously you had other training, so bit of a gutter. But when we're back, it'll be nice to have you back in.
Adriano, fuerte jugador, falta de Adriano Dungil sobre Santiago Irigoyte y tarjeta amarilla.
Oh, let's score a goal, Blues. Oh, let's
como
score
seca
a
el piso,
goal,
Santiago
Blues.
Irigoyte con la
Come
media.
On.
Está secando la parte de que está afectada por humedad.
I'm still hoping for my 3-2 scoreline. Come on.
Se va a venir variante en Astemio, se prepara Juan Martín Rosales, el número 5.
Two more goals, it's not a lot to ask for, is it?
Bien agrupado atrás.
So on this video, we've currently gone through 1 hour 31 minutes and 33 seconds, and the whole video is 1 hour 51 minutes.
Civitate Xavier.
So there's not a huge amount of time left.
Santiago Irigoyte.
So I've got a feeling this is not going to extra time.
Capitán Smith lo presiona Santiago, la roba Santiago.
Oh, bató, 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 bató. Penalty.
Penal.
Oh. Okay.
Penal para
Stevie. It's going penalty. Score or miss? Get in the comments nice and quickly. Score or miss? I'm gonna go score. Score or miss? Is he gonna take it to the Twitch sword? Or is it gonna be a goal? Callum said post. Jackson said score. Get those emojis ready. I'm getting that goal ready if he scores.
4:56 para que se vaya el partido.
Here we go. Jose said fails. Which means miss.
Dándoles
indicaciones. What's going to happen? Is it going to be a shield? Or is it going to be a goal?
El otro árbitro va a hablar con Alen. Habla con Alen.
Oh, come on, ref, get out of the way. I'm not going to hold my breath for that long. Alejandro said score. Oh. Goal! What was that goalkeeping? Golazo! Game on! I might have got this scoreline right. Haters will say I've pre-planned this. I can promise you I did not know the result today. Okay, let's go! And I generally don't know who won either.
Avanza Patrón, se hace sentir la parcialidad de Temios. Moisés Ferreira intentaba con su compatriota, con Alessandro Baugil.
Jose, what did the goalkeeper do? Jackson, goalie's a ballerina. I think what the keeper probably thought was he's going to aim for the top corners, so jump and make himself as big in the top corner as possible, and it just made him look stupid because he went low. It's very similar when you get a wall. You put a wall and they jump, and then the free kick taker kicks it underneath. I think that's kind of what's happened. I think he was generally expecting it to be the top corner. And when it works, you look like a genius, and when it doesn't, you look stupid. It's very similar in football when a penalty taker tries to chip it. When it goes in, you look like a genius. When you miss, you look like an idiot. Oh, I'm getting quite excited now. I think I might be right.
Score us a goal.
Well, at least we know we're going to see one more goal in this game, which is always exciting. Because this is a final, there has to be a winner. Good parallel. Ooh. That's a good example, by the way, of when you're working in dualities of a pass, cut, shoot. So if you hear a pass, cut, shoot, that's what that is. You don't necessarily have to play it parallel, but traditionally you see that a lot in futsal. Pass it parallel, they lay it off, you cut towards the ball, and then you strike. Jackson, to be fair, I couldn't score under that much pressure. Yeah, Jackson, that's the thing with these tournaments. It really, really does. You need a lot of nerve. Jose in the penalties.
Falta de Juan Martín Rosales.
I don't know what you mean there, but.
Venía para Moisés Ferreira. Antes la cabeza de Santiago Irigoyte. Allí va Adriano Baugil. Sacó atrás con Douglas Patrón. Mira el arco, mira compañía. Pide que se muevan sus compañeros. Dispara. ¡Ay, qué cerca! ¡Ay, qué cerca! ¡Ay, qué cerca! ¿Qué pasó? El disparo de Douglas Patrón.
Reciben son goles. Ah, right. Okay, Jose, I understand.
Juan Martín Rosales de izquierda.
Yes, exactly. And I think that's what the keeper's done. He's just picked a space. Mernies. Aguanta. And he assumed it was going to be wide. It was going to be high, sorry. Oh, counter-attack's on. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go! Oh, we found him. He did break that line. Couldn't finish. That's a shame.
En este caso, Smith, que buscaba a Adriano Baugil.
There is going to be a lot of goal-scoring opportunities down. Now the game's towards the end. Both teams are drawing. Both teams are just going to say, stuff it. Oh, it's a goal! It means I'm wrong, but it is a goal. Goal! It's a goal! Well, my prediction's out the window. I did say it was 3-2, but I said the other team. Jackson, I can deal with the pressure, but to play against such good teams is hard. It is, and you have to be mentally strong. You have to be mentally strong. But Jackson, again, for you, because you wouldn't have played opposition like this and played in the crowd like that, for you, your anxiety is going to be really high. But that's why I want to try and give all of you a lot of international experience and playing with crowds like this, because it then becomes normal. And then you can deal with that sort of pressure, you know? Because remember, it's just all in your head. You're in between lines with goalposts against opposition. Everything else is just a distraction. And what my job as manager would be to get rid of that anxiety and get you to focus on trying to win the game. Jose, good strategy.
Bueno, Fabiola Fernández, bien bató. Fabri Ruiz, durísimo rival. Sí, Fabri, durísimo rival. Este del Inbe 74. Que no va a entregar, que va a salir a buscar el empate también. Ahí la tiene el capitán Piñeiro. Dispara.
I've just got a feeling this might be it now.
Allí está el marco de público que está en las gradas o en una de las gradas que tiene este estadio Alberto de Ilhasanta de Praga,
If it finishes at 3-2 and I got the team wrong, that's fine. Arachanes, por ejemplo, I'll take half a right answer.
De la coqueta Rambla.
But no, my luck, there's going to be a few goals now, isn't
there? Del otro club,
just to give you an indication on the YouTube video, we're at 1 hour 38 and 40 seconds, and there's 1 hour 41 in total.
La pierna izquierda,
so there's still an opportunity of potentially more goals.
3-12 para que se vaya al partido. 3-2 gana Temios.
Jose, I don't speak Spanish, so I do apologize.
Santiago, Santiago, a la carga Temio, si viene el gol, Santiago Douglas. Lo tenía Bató y lo tenía Edison Gómez. Mirá cómo lo mira el negro Eddie. Douglas, patrón.
Maybe try Google Translate it.
Avanzando, se cierra Temio ahora. Douglas, patrón. Dispara. Cerca, cerca, arriba.
Again.
Arriba, arriba.
Alejandro, arriba. Second post, Jose. There you go. Alejandro, thank you very much.
Ahí va la reposición de Moisés Ferreira. Corto. Están pitando allí.
Yeah, Jose, it's a little bit ironic, isn't it? The whole first half, the objective for the Whites was to get two people round the post, and the only goal that's come at the post is the dark blues.
Juan Martín Rosales.
That must be a massive kick in the face. Good defending. Goal! My prediction's gone! Callum, how do you think about your prediction now? Oh my god, my prediction's gone. See, for any of the haters that's watching this video and thought I got it right, and thought, oh no, he already saw the result, blah, blah, blah. Perfect, I didn't even get the result right. Jose said that's the end. Callum West. Well, on the video, it's 1 hour 40, and in total, it's 1 hour 51. But that could be like celebration of the trophy, so I have no idea. But it can't be long left. But it means Blues can have a bit more fun now. So it might lead to more goals. Jose, thank you for coming, buddy. I will see you tomorrow. We have training at 4 o'clock and again a match in the evening at 8 o'clock. Thank you again for all your comments and I'll see you really soon. Callum West might get it right. You might do, to be fair, Callum. They score from here. Did you say 5-3 to the Dark Blues?
El rival de Astemios, el Inver 74. De aquí en más, serán tiros libres sin barrera.
The game is heating up.
El dale campeón, el grito de Astemios. Está consiguiendo un 4-2 hasta el momento. Que estuvo difícil en determinado momento del partido. Estuvo difícil porque es un buen equipo. Lo es un durísimo rival.
Alejandro, no worries, buddy. If you need to go now, you can go now. Oh, great movement.
La aguanta, toca atrás. Lo obliga. Patrón a sacar el balón a la tribuna.
Alejandro, are you training and watching the match tomorrow?
El saludo para Picho Pérez, para Luis Cheveste. Pronto. Te lo enviamos con Martín Corujo. La pronta recuperación para vos. Ya pronto vas a andar bien. Vamos arriba. A no decaer. Sebastián Mernies. Va larga. Bató. Llegaba por atrás. Alén Bató.
Oh, unlucky.
El bar... cruzó.
All they have to do now is waste a bit of time.
Abra el árbitro con los actores. El Pulpo Cazola. Hernán Rodríguez. Diego Sánchez, todos los jugadores viejos de Astemios están.
The Blues are not allowing them to get out, are they?
Queda la rambla. Esteban Coster, el cangrejo Hernández. Todos están simpatizando.
Jackson said he'll be there for both, and Alejandro said he'll be there for both. Fair play to you, lads.
Repone el Inve 74. Sale Leandro Piñeiro. Juan Martín Rosales que llega. Entrega. Lucha. Razón. Astemios ha dado vuelta este resultado. Ahora está dominando el partido. Ahí va Douglas, patrón. Avanza Douglas. Pelota al piso. A la izquierda. Leandro Piñeiro, el capitán. Recibe Adriano. Dispara pierna izquierda. Adriano. Va a un elemento. Pero algo para resaltar.
It'll be interesting to see how long's left. I want them to show us the time clock.
Este equipo no ha hecho variantes, se ha mantenido.
He's giving it away.
Titular, el que ingresó del minuto cero
See, this is why we love futsal. Dark Blues are winning, Whites were winning, and then Dark Blues are in front. It's unreal.
Jackson out, and he missed one session each in the first lockdown. Gómez
habla allí con Guillermo Smith. Se va el partido, se muere el partido. Victoria Astemio, la primera en casa. ¿Cuánto importa? Al pecho del el piso, la pelota. Atrás. Juan Martín Rosales. Lo anticipó Smith. Venía para el embato. No nos queremos imaginar lo que va a ser la revancha allá en Cerro Largo. Con el aliento de ese barrio del Imbe, que alentará a este equipo. Alem Bató, va Bató, engancha Bató, buen enganche Bató. Toca a la derecha, vino para Gómez.
¡Oh! No, no, ¡did it count! ¡Did it count!
Todos piden el gol.
Callum, this could be the difference from it being, you being right or wrong.
Sincero, el arquero podía haber estado adentro del arco, pero la pelota no traspasó en ningún momento.
Did he just give that as a goal? I don't think he did. I think he just stopped because they looked like they were scrapping or whatever. But
quiso Astemios y que ahora reclaman los jugadores de Astemios, pero la determinación por parte del el segundo asistente fue determinante.
Bro, what's going on?
Él está viendo la jugada prácticamente con un ángulo perfecto y vio que la pelota no traspasó la línea de gol, por eso que no se otorgó el gol en favor de Astemios.
¿Qué
es que ganó? Se le pitó una falta a Alem Bató. Por eso Astemio llega a la tercera falta. 5 tiene el Imbe. Están restando.
Even if it's a foul, why is he kicking it from there?
Paula Rocha, filetaciones, vamos por más.
That makes no sense.
Fernando Campot. El abrazo para Fernando. Allí sale el equipo de Imbe. Tocan a la derecha. Entre los brasileños se juntan. Adriano. Final. Ganó.
Game over. Okay, so guys, that was the end. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know the first half was not the best. However, what it does show is how amazing AMF Futsal is now that they've changed the rules. The old goalkeeper rule has massively improved since it was changed in 2019. And I really hope you enjoyed the second half because it was just a perfect example of what futsal is. It's not a version of football. It's a sport in its own right. It's dramatic. It's end-to-end. It's exciting. It's thrilling. And, you know, the Dark Blues were winning. The Whites were then winning. And then the Dark Blues took it at the end. It just, you know, even with the old rule that slightly ruined the game, and I will be honest, it slightly ruined the game, futsal prevailed and the excitement was there. And it's great, great to see. But anyway, another game tomorrow. More training tomorrow as well. I'm just going to try and get up on my phone just to let you know what's going on tomorrow. So tomorrow we will be doing Tuesday training. Bring Sally up, bring Sally down with a futsal twist. That's going to be hard. And in the evening, and I'm really psyched about this one, it's the women's quarterfinal from 2018, I think, or 2017. And it's the final, quarterfinal, between Paraguay and Italy. And I watched a very brief bit of this game, and it was a good game to watch. So make sure you're at training tomorrow at 4 o'clock. Make sure you're in the evening game at 8 o'clock. Have a fantastic evening, guys. It's been a pleasure to watch these games with you. And I will see all of you tomorrow at 4 o'clock. See you later, guys. Keep sharing that Twitch stream with your friends. Let's go!